This is me, and over here I have my Korean grandmother. I grew up in Singapore and would go back to Korea once every year to visit my mother's family. I fondly remember the cultural differences between both countries and how my Korean grandmother would always ask me, "야, 영어 발음이 영어로 말하는 것이 않고 중국말과 영어가 합해져서 들은 느낌이 있네." That was why, when I saw the trailer for Lee Isaac Chung's semi-autobiography Minari, I couldn't help but relate with the relationship between David, which is supposed to be his younger self, and the grandmother. With its theatrical release in 2021, the movie earned 6 nominations at the 93rd Oscars and won the Golden Globe for the Best Foreign Language Film. The movie is about a Korean immigrant family moving to rural Arkansas to start a new lease of life, or better known as the American Dream. Despite me never facing the hardships shown on screen, on my first watch, I couldn't help but connect with the family and its story. Minari gave me this feeling of warmth and comfort, and I needed to know why this film felt so personal to me. I then set out on a quest to answer that question. Today, I'll be looking at two aspects: the film's mise-en-scene and cinematography. The interior of the truck felt like home. Being half Korean, I could relate to the set design shown on screen. Right at the start, we were greeted with an empty truck, one ready to be furnished with plates, pictures, and books. Gradually, as the movie progressed, the truck started to feel a lot like home. Just like mine, there's a fusion between both cultures. There will be hints of Korean furniture, dolls, and cutleries, but at the same time, we are shown that the family has this desire to be part of the American culture by consuming American food, watching American media, and attending American church. The set design showed us the family's desire of wanting to be part of the American community while still holding true to their Korean heritage. This desire of wanting to assimilate is also shown in the costume design. Throughout the movie, all four of the family members, Jacob, Monica, David, and Anne, are often seen wearing red or blue, which are colors that are related to American patriotism. With the film centered around the goal of Jacob running a successful farm, naturally, one of the elements of success is water. Throughout the film, water is shown a lot. However, Jacob's obsession over his farm and water was what caused the rocky relationship between Jacob and Monica. Ironically, the element fire was what brought and banded the family together. Interestingly, that was the only time Jacob called Monica Yobo, which means honey. In conclusion, the film's mise-en-scene is purposeful in achieving its goal of portraying the family's values and their desires. Right from the opening scene, the film is framed in such a way where you can smell and feel the warmth of rural Arkansas. This is due to DP Lachlan Milne opting to use vibrant natural sunlight to light all of his sets. This helps to create a warm and optimistic atmosphere which shows the family's desire in wanting to live a better life. In addition, most of the film is shot using wide-angle lenses. This decision was made because they wanted to make everything seem bigger than it is, because you are looking at the world through the eyes of David. Most of the time, the camera is static, with not much movement. However, a handheld camera is used to film many of its emotional moments of the film, to help give this shaky and vulnerable effect for the viewers. Close-up shots were only used during moments of the film where either a character is making a decision or emotions are running high. The choices made were vital in setting the tone and atmosphere of the film, which helped make the characters feel vulnerable throughout its screen time. Minari is a film that I will hold dear to my heart, not only for the witty dialogue between David and Grandma, but also for the authenticity that the film brings. As director Lee Isaac Chung would best put it, I just wanted a story about fatherhood, about being a farmer, about being a husband, and about failure. Going through those things allowed for the family to be humanized. I don't have to go through what they did in order to connect with the family, because everything from the set design to the shot sizes were carefully selected in order for the audience to feel like they were a part of the family's journey from start to finish. To end this off, I cannot help but mention the poetic meaning behind the title, Minari. Minari is a plant where the first harvest cannot be eaten, but the second harvest of Minari is the one that can be eaten. Likewise, in any country, the first generation of immigrants are the ones that lay the foundations for the second generation to thrive. That was what made this film so distant, yet so personal.